Welcome, geometry students, to class today on this Friday the 29th. Hope you guys are doing well. Hope you're ready to learn some math or not learn some math. Hope you're ready to take a test today. And hopefully you're ready to display what you know so far. Jaden and Jordan, let me start off with you two guys. You did miss some class this week, so I am going to give you a choice as to whether or not you take the test. You missed, let's see, Tuesday and Wednesday, and you were back today. So that's going to be your call to make. However, you will have to take it by next Wednesday if you don't take it today. So if you do choose to take to take the test today, then it will count. And if you choose not to, that's fine. Okay, moving on. Go ahead and turn in your review sheets at this time. Jaden and Jordan, if you choose to take your test next week, then hold on to your review sheets so you can study them, and you can turn those in when you take your test. Okay, so hold on to your review sheets. The rest of you, go ahead and turn your review sheets in at this time. Incompletes, again, Jaden and Jordan, good job on turning in Monday's assignment. I appreciate that. You were also given an assignment on Wednesday, and you were not here for that. That's lesson 1.6. And so make sure you get that turned in. It is a zero until you get that turned in. And you should have that turned in within the next day or two. So there's no class on Monday, students. It's Labor Day. So these things here should be turned in by Tuesday or Wednesday of next week. Okay? All right, continuing on. Let's see what else we have here. Let's go ahead and go over your tests. That should say tests, not quizzes. Let's go ahead and go over your tests at this time. If the tests have not been passed out, then go ahead and pause the video and don't restart it until everyone has a test on their desk, okay? Students, everything that I say now, you're welcome to write on your test. I don't mind that. If you'll go ahead and look at the first page, of your test, you'll see numbers 1 through 18 are all fill in the blank, and you should have a word bank. And you should have a word bank to choose from on the first page. Take a look at that. And sorry about the noise there, guys. My kids just walked in the house. Sorry about that. So on the first page there is fill in the blank. Numbers 1 through 18, be sure and use your word bank. Go ahead and flip your test over and look at the back side there. Numbers 19 and 20, you're going to look at those shapes and figures and figure out what comes next in the pattern and then write that in the blank. Do the best you can with drawing those figures. Numbers 21 and 22, you're going to look at the patterns and then figure out the next two numbers that come in those patterns. Okay, so 21 and 22. 23 and 24, these are pretty good thinking problems. Let me get a drink here real quick. And so you're going to have to read 23 and 24. The reason I don't read them out loud is because I don't want on YouTube videos for my test to be out there for people to see or hear. And so that's why I'm not actually reading the problems. But you have to look at 23 and 24 and just kind of figure out, how can I prove that wrong? And you have to get, like, number 23, you're going to have to give me two rectangles in order to prove that wrong. Number 24, you're going to have to give me a math problem, a sum problem, that proves that conjecture wrong. So please work hard on those. And hopefully you'll do well on those. Let's take a look now at the next page on your test. Numbers 25 through 29. Let's see. Name a point that's coplanar with plane Q and K. I'm not going to read all of these to you, but it's pretty self-explanatory. You should be very familiar with points, lines, planes, intersection points, etc. So 25 through 29, be sure and use the figure at the right there. Numbers 30 and 31, use those segments to solve for a length. Number 30, you're going to find the length of DF. And number 31, you're going to find the length of ST, okay? Notice that on number 31, 30 is the measurement of the entire segment, RT. If you'll look at numbers 32 and 33, we're going to find some missing angles. And so number 32, we're going to find the measure of angle STR. And then number 33, we're going to find the measure of angle DEF. And can I say something, students, real quick? Please listen to me carefully. On number 33, that 150 degrees, that goes for the entire big angle CEF. Let me say that again. For number 33, the 150 degrees goes for the entire angle CEF. And then lastly, one more problem. I want you to write that angle three different ways. I have taught you three different ways in which you can write angles. So go ahead and write that angle three different ways, and that's it. Hope you guys do well on your test. I hope you've studied, and I hope you have prepared for this test. Have a great weekend. Keep continuing to work hard in this class, and go ahead and get started on your test now at this time.